You're watching the Wellness Hour, news that makes you healthier. I'm Randy Alvarez. Today's topic, replacing missing teeth with dental implants. We've had him on the program before, and he always says nobody should be wearing a loose fitting denture. With us we have from Clear Choice Dental Implant Centers, Dr. Daniel Galindo. Dr. Galindo, welcome to the program.
Randy, thanks for having me again.
All right, now we were talking, you know, for people that don't know Clear Choice, I mean, you've been there almost from the beginning, like 9 years.
From day one, 9 years.
This. Now, for people that don't know Clear Choice, like who's the typical patient and what are the different services that you offer?
The typical patient is that patient that has been struggling with their teeth or dentures for a long time. People that have either sought dental care and the treatment has not responded because of different reasons, or people that have checked out and have not returned to see a dentist because they have been just frustrated, afraid, intimidated. They fear being judged when coming to a dental office. So the category of patients that we see are those that are facing dentures because of the dental condition, either gum disease, broken teeth, partials that are not working for them anymore, or people that have been using dentures for a long time and are just frustrated with them.
And you're saying that even if you've been wearing dentures like 20 years, you still can do this?
You can still do it.
Isn't it true you don't have enough bone, though, to do it?
Well, we have the technology in our center to be able to take a CAT scan that allows us to see if one is a candidate or not. I think the biggest problem is that people think that they're not candidates because they've had a denture for a long time, they're assuming, they've heard stories, but the reality is that until we see that x-ray, until we study the bone, they might still be a candidate. And,
okay.
And there are surprises every day.
Many of them have no teeth on the day of the procedure and they walk out with a full arch of teeth on the upper and lower that don't come in and out.
Correct.
Is that right?
99% of our patients. Barring any medical condition, we will look at the case, we will understand what the x-rays are telling us, where the bone is, and where we can place implants, and we can deliver on our promise to the patient.
Now, as the prosthodontist, people need to know, I guess you have a model, which is unique, where you have the oral surgeon that works there, the specialist prosthodontist, which is you, that works there, that designs the beautiful teeth, and you guys work together. So everything is done right there?
Everything is done right at our center. So we've put together under the same roof, the oral surgeon, the prosthodontist, the lab technicians that help me with the design and fabrication of the teeth, plus the CAT scan. So in just one place, we're talking real time, we're just walking a few steps, we're a few steps away from each other, and we can answer each other's questions for the benefit of our patients.
Now people travel, I mean you're in Phoenix, but people travel from all over Arizona to see you?
From all over Arizona, and sometimes from out of Arizona as well.
Is that right? Now you know, we were talking, because you've been on my show a few times, I've interviewed you on three different occasions, but you say they've been watching the show and they're still skeptical. That means they go in and they still don't believe it could be done.
So,
what do they say?
It's not unusual for somebody to come over to our center and tell me, I've been watching you for the last 4 years, and when I turn the TV on and you're talking to Randy, it's like you're talking to me.
Is that what they say?
And I asked them, why did you have to wait so long? He says, well, I still thought that I wasn't a candidate. I was self-eliminating myself from being a candidate. But they came in today and we're looking at them and start the process of.
So when you say, look, we could do this, they say, are you sure?
I get that asked a few times. Are you sure? And I tell them with certainty, yes, we can.
Okay, and most of these patients have some sort of sedation during the process?
Yes, the procedure's done under IV sedation so that the patient is comfortable throughout the procedure.
Are there still that many people in Arizona? Look, you've been doing a long time. You've been there, what, 9 years?
9 years.
Okay, and you're one of the busiest guys. Are there still people left? Are there that many people in Arizona that have either headed to dentures or are wearing a denture?
Yes. Yeah. There's a lot of people that don't realize that they don't have to continue living their lives with dentures. A lot of people that have been battling their dental disease for a long time. There's the need is there.
Who is the more common? The denture wearer that wants to stabilize their denture or get permanent teeth that don't come in and out? Or the person that their teeth are hanging on by a thread
That's the most common patient.
That's the most common.
The most common. The people that have, you know, gone through the dental process of trying to hold onto some teeth, even though the teeth might be weak, get partial dentures, get bridges, and eventually the teeth are just giving up on them. And they're just a step away from having to commit to a denture. Well, there's an option. There's an alternative. There's implants allow people to have a third set of teeth.
Okay, this is like the third set of teeth.
How
soon can they eat after the day of the procedure where you actually give them the permanent set of teeth?
They can eat right after we place the teeth. And this is what's so incredible about this treatment. I hear patients that they've been longing to eat a steak. They've had to avoid it. They had to change their diet because of their teeth. Yesterday, before I left the office, I placed a permanent set of teeth, and the patient asked me, "Can I eat popcorn now?" I says, "Yeah, for sure. You can eat popcorn."
So salads. Now. I mean, could they bite of vegetables with their front teeth, like
yes.
a carrot, like a raw carrot?
Raw carrot, apples. That's the most frequent food item that I get questions about. When will I be able to eat an apple again without slicing it?
So really, they could eat whatever they want. Whatever you could do with a normal set of teeth.
Yes.
So what about maintenance? Okay, so you've given them a permanent set of teeth on the upper and lower, maybe somebody that was a denture wearer. How do they take care of them?
The same care that I take with my teeth. The procedures that you do at home, brushing, flossing, and then we're gonna see them every 6 months with our hygienist. We have two hygienists in our office that help patients take care of their teeth. It's a very simple procedure.
You know, I should mention, look, we've had the Wellness Hour TV show. This is 18 years, right? And I've had a lot of medical doctors and a lot of dentists on the show. And, you know, people need to know it is a real interview. I'm not trying to endorse you. I'm just asking the questions. But in this case, I am endorsing you. I mean, you're one of the most experienced guys I've ever met. And I told you that when you walked in. I was joking. I said, "Oh, the king of dental implants." You said, no. But I mean, you're one of the busiest guys with the most experience at doing this.
Yeah, luckily we've been busy at our center and has allowed us to touch so many lives, improve on what people are living with year after year. Very rewarding.
So there's still thousands of people in Arizona.
Still thousands of people.
And you say they come in, this is interesting. I know it is to me, that they come in thinking they're the worst ever. Elaborate on that.
People really don't know what other people have in terms of their dental situation. Somebody that's struggling with their teeth will not smile, so they will not show it to everyone. So the reality is that people will tell me, "I must be the worst case that you have ever seen." And I've seen some pretty extreme cases, but you know, fortunately, we have the ability, we have the experience to be able to help these very complicated cases.
You say these people never smile, so they never see it.
They never see it. And people that don't smile, you know, their neighbor doesn't know, their family member doesn't know. It's just, they're self-diagnosing themselves.
Okay, now, how old can you be to get this? Like, what are some of your older patients?
Oh, patients in their early to mid-90s.
Is that right? Now, and why would they want to do it at 90 years old?
They still feel young. They still want to enjoy a healthy diet, have an active lifestyle. They've heard that their parents or grandparents or other family members have struggled with dentures, and they don't want to be there.
So they could eat nuts and things like that?
They can.
So no problem with any of those. Now, no. I know you brought new photos.
I did.
You always have a lot of these photos.
Yes.
So what are we looking at?
So we're looking here at Manuel.
Okay.
And Manuel came to our office with his wife, and there was an important family event coming up, and his wife was preparing some photographs to reminisce on their daughter. And the one thing that she said is, "I've looked at photographs of us for the last 20 years, and he is not smiling. I cannot find a picture of him smiling," which is very telling. Just think about that,
yeah.
Andy. Just not smiling for photos for 20 years. It's gotta be difficult.
So is this his version of a smile?
That is his version of a smile.
Because he just never smiles.
He never smiles. He learned how to hide it, and it wasn't until his wife started to look for photographs that she realized he hasn't smiled in so many years. And now he's a completely different person. He
wow.
is a public speaker. He is in the reserve of law enforcement, and now he can go to events, feel comfortable about himself, and certainly just show his smile that makes him very proud.
And these are permanent teeth. I mean, these
are permanent
the fixed teeth. The fixed teeth.
Those are permanent teeth.
Now, you know, we've had people on the program where they do a lot of these snap-in, snap-out teeth. You, at Clear Choice, and correct me if I'm wrong, that you like teeth that don't come in and out, like a fixed set of teeth.
Like natural teeth.
All right.
So the dentures that snap on implants, it's basically still a denture. It has the maintenance issue of the parts that wear down because of the friction of putting it in and out, and it's still a denture. You still need to take it out at night. You still need to drop it into that jar with water. You still need to brush it outside of your mouth. Permanent teeth are teeth that you brush inside of your mouth, you sleep with them, you leave the house with them. You're not thinking about what you need to do to keep the teeth in your mouth.
Okay, good. And financing, you say every single day people are financing this.
Yeah, people finance this treatment. It's going to be an investment, and we have patient education consultants that discuss the financing options with patients to make sure that they can benefit from this treatment. It's not unusual for patients to come into the office and say, I have family members that are gonna help me. How can we put this together? So, Randy, this is a very exciting case.
All right.
This patient had braces when she was in her teens and started to have problems soon after that. And little by little, she kept losing her teeth. Very attractive woman. She used to model. And as she began to lose her teeth, her daily struggle was fitting the dentures, the partial dentures, in her mouth so that she could be presentable, so that her husband can see her the way she was 10, 15 years ago. So her options were either get dentures or get teeth with implants. And that's what we did for her. She has permanent teeth supported by implants.
That looks very nice. Looks very nice.
This is a smile that she's confident about. She's comfortable. She can face the people that she needs to interact with, and she doesn't have to worry anymore about gluing the teeth in her mouth, them coming loose on her. She can sit at a business meeting, eat whatever she wants, just not think about her
just
teeth
like
anymore.
Regular teeth.
Just like
regular teeth.
Because
she's too young to be wearing or having dentures.
Anybody's too young to be wearing dentures. Anybody's too young.
Do you think this is, I think I've asked you before on other shows that, is this a future of dentistry? Like whether it's 100 years from now, but everybody, dentures as we know them today, in the future, everything will always be attached to something?
That's the way we're heading, because we have changed in the way we deliver care. The treatment options have evolved, and this is where we are right now. Considering a denture versus dental implants, if medically you're a candidate, this is what is going to deliver the comfort that you had when you had your own teeth.
Now, you know, it's interesting. You say that people watch you sometimes for a year or 2 years before they finally do it. And then they come in, they feel like they know you.
Yeah, they'll tell me, I turn the TV, you're talking to Randy, but it's like you're talking to me. I've been watching you for the last 2-3 years. They know
who I am. Somebody hugged you, even before the procedure.
The day that I'm meeting them, because they know me, because they can relate that some of the patients that I'm talking about today, it's them. So take a look at the before and after in her case.
Mm-hmm.
She looks like a completely different person. When she came and met me for the first time, she told me at some point that she was considering facial surgery, plastic surgery, because of what she was seeing. I said, wait, get your teeth done, because your face is going to change completely. Not only did the structures around her mouth change, but her eyes are different. Her whole appearance is completely different.
Now, we've had these discussions that people with bad teeth, and they do this in the movies, if you want to make somebody look poor, you give them really bad teeth, the people are discriminated or judged based on their teeth.
That's true. And I hear that from the patients that come and visit us. Not having teeth, it's like your teeth are your business card. when you're meeting somebody, when you're talking to somebody, at some point your teeth are going to show.
Yeah.
And it reflects on you. So this next story is of a person that is also a public speaker. And he had done his dental work, and at his last dental visit, he was told that 3 out of the 6 remaining teeth had to come out. And he was thinking, what am I going to do? His backstory is that his dad had weak teeth, his mom had strong teeth, and he blames that he had his dad's teeth. So little by little, he was adapting to the idea that he was going to lose his teeth and that he was facing getting a denture. But with his line of work, of talking to people, of engaging people, he said, I'm going to look for something different.
So I heard about you guys.
He heard about us when the partial broke for the 5th, 6th time, and he came and visited us, and we looked at his medical condition, we looked at his CAT scan, he had enough bone, and one day we gave him the new permanent teeth.
Let's take a look at this.
So that is his before, and this is his after.
Oh my goodness.
It's a wider smile, it's a broader smile. He is a very charming individual. He has the power of engaging people with a smile. And he says he's back. He found
himself.
It's
like their mojo's back.
He's back. He found himself again.
These are, I mean, this is like cosmetic dentistry. They look like veneers to me.
They look like veneers.
I mean, they look good. They actually look like regular teeth to me. But what I mean is it's like a perfect smile.
And this is a permanent set of teeth made with zirconia, a strong material. You can bite, you can chew. With him, the most incredible thing was when he was holding the mirror for the first time, as soon as we seated his teeth. He just couldn't believe himself. He couldn't believe that that person in the mirror was him 20 years ago. He saw it. His eyes lightened up. It was very emotional.
Now, do they cry sometimes? Or even their spouses? See it, and everybody gets emotional. I think you told me that,
Randy. You know, I hate to admit it, but several of us get teary-eyed at that time.
Get choked up just talking about.
Yeah, just the emotional part of it. You know, this treatment is not only about teeth, not only about being able to get the ability to chew food. It's holistic.
Nice.
Health improves. People feel better. It's very emotional.
Okay, good. We're going to take a quick break. We come back. More about the process, more of these photos, and we're short on time. You're watching The Wellness Hour. I'm Randy Alvarez. We'll be right back.
I've been in sales for a long time, dealing with clients one-on-one. With the denture, every time I smiled, I had to cover my mouth because I was so ashamed.
I was in a boating accident, damaged a lot of my teeth. Went through 2 major oral surgeries. I basically didn't eat. Then I came to Clear Choice.
The Clear Choice One Day approach is making dental implants a reality for people all over the country who suffer from missing or failing teeth.
We transform lives in one day. You walk out of here with a set of teeth that you can go to a restaurant with, you can eat, you can smile.
When they handed me the mirror, the first thing I did was cry with joy.
Discover why this is so much more than another dental procedure. It's a true life changer. With over 30,000 new smiles across our network, we're lifting spirits and confidence all over America. Schedule your free consultation today. We'll even talk about financing options.
I can smile, my confidence is back.
And look, I mean, they're beautiful.
Call Clear Choice today.
You're watching The Wellness Hour, news that makes you healthier. I'm Randy Alvarez. Today's topic, replacing missing teeth with dental implant. Permanent teeth done in one day. We've had him on the program before, board certified prosthodontist, Dr. Galindo. Dr. Galindo, welcome back to the program.
Thanks, Randy. So let me show you this case now.
All right.
This patient had been struggling with periodontal disease for the better part of his adult life. He's in his early 40s. He had told me that he started his periodontal treatment in his late teens. And when he presented to the office, his complaint was that his gums were bleeding, his teeth were loose. He had visited his dentist and he had been told, it's time for your dentures. He was not ready for it and was wondering, what could we do? He was seeing his grandfather and in himself having to deal with dentures. And of course he came in, we did the consultation, we did the CAT scan. We looked at him and told him, you are a great candidate for dental implants and you can have permanent teeth. You don't have to worry about dealing with dentures. And he agreed to the treatment.
You said you get excited on some of these consults.
I do.
Like they have low goals and you have big goals. Like they don't even know, you said in the green room, how good it's gonna be. Elaborate on that.
Well, he didn't know what was coming on, what was available for him in the future. He's very depressed and trying to look at a lifeline for himself. And he found us.
All right.
And we completed his treatment in one day. And
let's take a look.
His gum disease.
Oh my goodness, a young guy.
He's a young person. His gum disease was cleared out. The teeth were not going to make it. And now his bone is healthy. His gums are healthy. He feels comfortable with himself. He says it's the most rewarding thing he has ever done for himself. And he's a young person.
So again, big guy, you can eat whatever you want.
You can eat whatever you want.
Like even chewy things?
Chewy things. He can eat steak. He can eat chewy things. He can enjoy salads. He works at one of the local zoos. He takes care of the reptiles. He needs to grab food on the go because he needs to be taking care of the animals that he's looking after. So he can now enjoy the foods that he wants to enjoy.
Now, you were talking about bleeding gums, loose teeth, but if your gums are bad, how are the implants able to stay in there? I mean, if you have bad gums, you could still do this?
That's a question that I get asked every day because people have been dealing with gum disease for a long time. What sometimes patients don't understand is that the gum disease is a function of the teeth. But once the teeth are removed, that bone can be preserved with the dental implants.
And the gums get healthy?
And the gums get healthy. Here's another example.
All right.
Here's another example of a young patient that had been dealing with a progressive loss of teeth. The treatment that she was getting was not working for her. And she got to a point, again, where it was dentures or implants. And she had done some research. She had educated herself. And one of the things that we do is we explain to patients what the different treatment options are. Not everybody knows about dental implants at this point. Again, once we told her that we could change her life, she was so excited about it. So look at her smile in that before photo. Look at how that lip is trying to protect the fact that she doesn't have some of her teeth. And now look at the smile at the end of treatment. Wow.
Yeah.
It's a completely different smile. Look at how broad it is. Look at how her eyes are opening. It's life-changing.
So when I look at her front teeth, there's like a little bit of an oval going on, shape. So who designs the teeth? I mean, are you in on it?
That's what I do as a prosthodontist. And it's the most exciting process because you have to create a smile that's going to fit the person that you're treating. This is not the same smile for everybody. Everybody's different. The shape of our face is different. The way we show the teeth is different. So every smile is custom made for each one of our patients.
So no more dentures. Like she would have had a denture.
She would have had a denture.
Yeah, I mean that just looks like a world-class smile.
It's a beautiful smile and a smile for years to come.
Okay, good. And I'm not trying to side with you so much, but these photos kind of speak for themselves. I think anybody would agree.
I understand. It's difficult. I mean, it's so rewarding to see what we can do to impact somebody's life.
Okay, good.
Here's another patient. She had been losing her teeth, and she had no teeth in her lower jaw. So the interesting thing is that you can see her smile, how she's learned to protect the lower teeth.
She like guards her smile.
She's completely guarded. That lower lip is tight, and it's tight so that her lack of teeth is not shown when she smiles. The partial denture was only holding from 6 teeth on the upper jaw, and those teeth were loose. Again, she did not want to just get a denture. She had a denture held by 2 implants in the lower jaw, but it wasn't enough for her. Looked at the bone, look at her medical condition, a candidate, and now look at her smile.
Very nice.
She feels comfortable, no more disease, no more guarding herself. As she's facing people in her daily life.
Now, these people, you say you see personality changes sometimes, like people that you thought maybe were shy, or a guy that you thought maybe was a tough guy. And then they get their teeth and they're charming and happy. And
And the question that they ask themselves is, where was I? And of course, I only...
What do you mean by that? What do you mean by that?
Well, they've kind of put themselves in a box. And that charming personality is hidden because as you and I are talking, I'm smiling, you're smiling, we're showing our teeth, we feel comfortable. A lot of people don't feel comfortable like that. So they're protecting themselves, they're sheltering themselves, they're not being who they really are. And I'm meeting the shy person for the first time. So as I see, as I'm doing their treatment, they're evolving and they're back to who they were before. And I'm kind of meeting a new person as as they evolve.
Now, you know, I've seen your commercial, which I love this commercial where there's a fireman. And he said, I couldn't even laugh at their jokes before. Is that common?
It is common.
Where?
It is common because, you know, there's a risk with smiling. There's a risk with laughing. If you have a denture, we've seen the viral videos of the lovely grandmother that smiles and laughs and her dentures pop out of her mouth. You know, it is cute, but is that really something that you want to live with?
Yeah, the person that happens to, that must be very embarrassing.
It has to be very embarrassing.
Now, we are completely out of time. So what do you say, though, to the person? Because you say some people have watched our interview for 2 or 3 years, and they put it off and put it off and finally do it. So what do you say to the people that are watching this, and they're still afraid, right? They're afraid of the dentist. Or they think their gums are too bad or whatever.
Give yourself a chance. It's a free consultation. Come talk to us. We'll tell you what the options are, what we can do for you, and see if you want to move forward.
So in a perfect world, somebody sees this show today, how soon, and they have no teeth, zero teeth. And if everything works out, how soon could they have a full set of teeth that don't come in and out?
A few weeks. It happens really fast. We have to, we start the process by custom designing the teeth, and then from there on, we get the process started.
Teeth that don't come in and out in one day is not just a marketing slogan. That's
no,
real.
It's a reality.
And there's still people left that are headed to dentures or missing teeth in Arizona that...
They need to come and talk to us. They need to come educate themselves. We're happy to do it and happy to get them started. Take the first step in changing their life.
Okay, good. I want to thank you for coming on the show. Always a pleasure.
Thanks, Randy.
You've been watching The Wellness Hour. I'm Randy Alvarez for now. I wish you good health.
Thanks for watching The Wellness Hour, the leader in medical news with your host, Randy Alvarez, the authority on health issues.